Halloween, and welcome back to another snail mail vlog. It is that time of the week when I have popped over to our PO box, opened it up, and basically have been washed away by a tsunami of amazing letters and packages, and this is awesome. Oh my gosh. Okay, so as usual, I am so excited. It is like Christmas and kind of like my birthday all wrapped up in one, only it's even better because it's your guys' beautiful creations and your wonderful letters, and it's absolutely fantastic. And this is the part where I need to warn you guys, we are moving. It is only a month from now when we are going to be moving away from North Carolina up into Michigan. And so the PO box is closing. It is going to be closed at the end of July. And so you should probably hold on to anything if you're planning on shipping anything. Hold on to that. Wait until after we move. I will be opening up a new PO box once we get to Michigan. And after that, hopefully that one can stay open consistently for like years. So we'll have to see, because snail mail, oh, your guys' stuff that you send, the beautiful creations that you do, look at all of this stuff. I've got all sorts of cool seashells everywhere. I've got clay art. I've got beautiful artwork that I want to put up on my walls, and like scrapbooks full of your letters. I love that. I'm going to have a whole office to show all of that off soon. It's going to be fantastic. So it'll be all of that stuff you see behind me pretty soon. Can you spot Yarny? Look at Yarny. He's hiding up there. He's so cute. But yeah, so we are going to be moving pretty soon, and that means the PO box is going to be closing. So I wouldn't risk sending anything unless you live like practically in North Carolina. And even then, sometimes I get letters like 2 or 3 weeks just because they bounce around the postal service after people send them. It doesn't happen too often, but I don't want to lose any of your stuff, and I'm not sure if they'll actually forward the things from my PO box to our new place. I don't know if it'll actually work. So hold on to your stuff, you guys. I love getting snail mail, but you really, 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 really may want to hold on to it so that it gets to me, to make sure it gets to me. So yeah, that little like public service announcement aside, let's dive in. This is actually only half of the snail mail that we have to dig into this week. I'll be releasing another video in a few days, and then another one after that, because we have so much snail mail because you guys are amazing. So let's go ahead and see what you guys have sent this week. And we have one from Lissy. Lissy in Ohio. Oh, it's got flowers and little hearts on the back. That's so cool. You can show and read everything on camera, it says. Oh, thank you so much. Okay, it's very important to do that. If you don't want me to read stuff on camera, put it on the letter, and then I can set it aside to read privately. It's so much fun. All right, so let's see. There's pictures in here. Let's see what's over here. Oh, it's a kitty. Look at that kitty. All right, let's see what this says. Let's pop this open. Seri, you're allowed to read on camera. Dear Seri, hi Seri, it's me, Lissy. I just wanted to say how totally excited I am for all the new series coming up and the series I enjoy right now. My favorite series right now is Star Stable. Oh, I'm excited too. I'm actually going to record some Star Stable after this is over. There's apparently a hibiscus shirt. Somebody like tweeted or emailed me a picture of a hibiscus shirt that's on sale in the mall right now, and I totally want to get it, and I'm really excited about that. Oh, I love sharing these adventures with you guys. Oh my gosh. Okay, too excited. Too excited. It's because I'm thinking about my office and all of the stuff that I'm going to be able to decorate with all of your pictures everywhere. Oh, it's going to be awesome. I can't wait. I'm going to need so many bookshelves and so many frames for all of the awesome art. Anyway, Lissy, in Star Stable, I think your next horse should definitely be the forest horse. But to be fair, I think that all the horses in Star Stable are all beautiful. Anyways, I'm also very excited for the dinosaur side series, which I totally want to make happen this summer. I am determined, determined. Oh, I'm going to do my best. Anyways, can I ask you some questions? Wait, why am I asking you if you can't answer? Anyway, here are my questions. Please answer them. What series do you enjoy making the most? Oh, that's a good one. Oh boy, what series do I enjoy making the most? You know, I really love all of the series that we make. The one I struggle the most with is Wolf Quest, because it's the same two levels over and over again. But your stories and artwork and the letters and people who love Wolf Quest make it so I keep going. What do I enjoy? I am so proud. I think I'm the most proud when I finish a Warrior Cats episode, because it's so much work. Because that represents like probably half an hour to an hour of looking over the plots that I have that may die at any time because of the way the game changes things. And writing up stuff, and then like another hour to 2 hours of recording, and then an hour to 2 hours of editing and uploading and processing and all of that stuff. So it's a lot of work, and I'm really proud, and I know that so many people are going to really enjoy it, and it's definitely a fun creative exercise to do Warrior Cats. So what do I enjoy making the most? Sims is definitely any of the Sims. I just have a natural passion for playing Sims, and I love Sims. So I know I really am happy when I'm allowed to sit down and play those, because, and I do say allowed because I stick to such a strict schedule. But zoo crafting is like going home. It really does feel like logging on and being in another house that I have that's been part of my life for years now. So that's a real, I think I'm able to keep so many series going because I really enjoy truly some aspect of each and every one of our series. So I kind of, and Stardew Valley. Stardew Valley is just pure bliss for me because I love that game so much. I would have to say that for ease, it's definitely Stardew Valley. Hours can pass playing that game before I realize it. And for like creative effort, Warrior Cats. For familiarity, it's definitely zoo crafting. I mean, I love all of it. What do you guys like the most? I love Star Stable and its adventures. I really do love all of our series. Something I don't really click with won't stay around very long because we have so many other adventures to tell. I'm not gonna spend time on something that I just don't really have a spark with. So yeah, I think, you know, it really depends on what mood I'm in, and it really depends on what we're talking about in terms of like ease of recording something. I mean, Horse Haven I'm even amused by because it's like, oh, am I gonna have luck with that random generator today and see if I can breed up my rare foals? So yeah, it really depends on the mood I'm in, but I really do love all of our series, especially I think knowing that they're gonna make people happy when I'm done recording them. That makes me pretty happy. Hem. Will you ever do a series with chips there? Maybe Minecraft, Wolf Quest, or just having him in the background talking? We've actually talked about that. He loves Civ, so for a while, a long time ago, we actually planned on doing a Civ series together. Then we planned on playing Ark together. But Chips is very, very busy because he's studying for his PhD. His classes officially start in August. So he spends hours and hours every day studying his Chinese and studying so many other things. So then when he does have his downtime, like recording for an audience versus playing for yourself is two different things. But I would love to see if he'd get on sometime, even just for like some specials. So we'll look into that in the future. We've talked about it. Since you don't want children. What would you possibly adopt a child or two? What do you think? We actually have a lot of adopted children in my family. Both my nieces, my cousins, not my nieces. There's such a huge age difference. I keep calling them my nieces, but both of my cousins are adopted that I nannied for years. And then I don't think we have any other immediate adoptions, but there's not really a lot of young kids in the family. But Chips and I, our energy level, we're just not. I'm gonna be a great auntie, but we're not planning on ever having kids, even though I'm really good with kids and I've been a nanny and I've been an elementary school teacher and I was a foster mother. I was a foster mother for medical needs babies. The kind, like, I lived with my aunt and she was like the main foster parent and then I was the co-foster parent. And we did that for like almost 4 years. And those were like short-term fosters where like parents had to be educated or maybe get out of jail and some their kid needed to go somewhere and their child would have usually we did age range from like 0 to about 3 to 4 years. So I have been a foster parent. I have taken care of kids. I love kids. I love teaching kids. And I love my cousins and my niece and I'm sure I'm gonna love all of my nieces and nephews. But I think because I lived that for like the last 8 years, daily taking care of children, in some cases children who had to go have chemotherapy, in some cases like children who had to have like extensive speech therapy or physical therapy, and grew up watching my brothers with speech therapy, I know how much work it is. And I've worked really hard. And ever since I've been little, like my family has needed my extra care because both my parents are disabled, and that came out of the blue, and both that happened to both of them. So I'm kind of tired, and I know that sounds weird, but people ask me a lot, and I want to give a full answer that it's a lot more complicated than just do you like kids, do you not like kids. When you realize how much work it is, and you already have such a loving and big family. Sometimes it's just not the extra thing you need, and especially having been a foster parent, I really wish people would think more seriously about adding a child into their family and the impact that that has and the responsibility of bringing a new life into the world or even just adding a new life into your family can have. So it's a really serious and personal answer, but That's why we're good. We're good. We're good, and I love my niece and my cousins, and I'm gonna love all of the future nieces and nephews that I have too, and any other cousins I might have added. I just had a cousin be born, actually. I just had a second cousin be born, like a few days ago, and she's adorable. And I love them, but especially having done it, especially having woken up at 3 a.m. to feed like 3 different crying babies, I know how much work it is, and I respect it enough to know that it's not in the cards for me right now. It's not something I 100% want to do. And if you don't 100% want to like have a child, don't do it. Just don't. Please don't. Trust me. I've been there. I've seen the results. Don't do it. So that's why. So not in the cards, but we plan on going on lots of adventures. And it's also something when I know my health may not always stay the best. I don't know what the next 10 years are going to look like for me health-wise. That I have to be serious. Do I want to bring a child into my life and then face the reality that maybe I won't be able to get out of bed in 8 years? Is that fair? I don't think it is. So that's kind of like where that super serious, over serious answer is. But I get that question a lot every week. So I figured I'd go ahead and really answer it this time. And then, what's your real name? My real name has been revealed multiple times, but I like to kind of tease you guys by not saying it. But it is a 4-letter word, and it does begin with S, and it is a plant, and I'll just leave it at that. And then, why are you vegan? And that's really complicated. You're asking so many complicated questions, but it's really cool. I like it. It shows that somebody who's thinking hard. The basic rule of thumb is I've gone hunting before, and I don't need to. I don't need to eat meat right now, and I don't need to eat dairy, and I don't need to do any of that to survive. I have a really great diet, actually, and I really, really love the food we eat. And I have this rule of thumb where if I don't kill it myself, I'm not going to eat it. And so I have the option. If I truly wanted to go eat some venison, then I can go out and kill a deer. And if I am sitting there staring at the deer, that's where I have my choice of, like, do I want the meat more than I want to sit and watch the deer? And so far the answer has always been I would rather watch the deer, watch the fish, watch the shrimp, move around and do its thing while it's alive than kill it and eat it. And that's kind of my rule of thumb, and it's like a hard and fast rule of thumb. And I think it's just my way of personally taking responsibility, of being able to be like, well, if I really, really want something, then I deserve to respect it enough to kill it myself. And if the answer is I don't want to do that because I'm squeamish or because, and I'm not, or because I just enjoy watching it move around alive more than I do want it on my plate, then I'll leave it alone. And that's kind of where I've been at. So that's like, it's not very complicated for me. It's just my way of trying to keep things fair and trying to not contribute to the bigger environmental issues at hand, which as a biologist is really important to me. So that's kind of where I'm at. It's a much simpler answer than Chips's answer to why he's vegan, but that's kind of my rule of thumb. If I don't kill it myself, I don't eat it. And thus far, I haven't had the urge to eat something enough to kill it. So that's sort of why I'm vegan. All right. Also, Seri, I cannot believe you are moving to Michigan. You know why? Because I live in Ohio. That's so close. So now I'll be able to do a meetup with you one day. Also, I love you so much. Not in the creepy way, lol. I just love how joyful you are about everything. So I just can't even explain it. I can't even explain it. Anyway, now you can look at the fan art. I made several ponies for you, a wolf and a piece of Star Stable fan art. And those pictures are a couple from my field trip at the zoo and an awful picture of my cat named Baby. She's 8 years old. Anyway, gotta go. Bye. Love, Lizzie. And this is Stay Curious on the back. Oh, that's so fun. Thank you, Lizzie. And thank you for the questions. I probably answered like way mega serious, but I think you guys can handle it. And I think you guys, it helps to have serious answers sometimes. So here's Baby, 8-year-old kitty cat. Look at that. Oh, she's so cute. She's so cute. You know, there's going to be a cat cafe that we're going to go to in Michigan, and I plan on going there monthly. So if you guys want to see the cat cafe that we're going to be going to in Michigan, it's a rescue cat cafe. So you can actually adopt the cats that you see. It's affiliated with the rescue society in the city we're moving to. So I thought that was really cool. But if you guys want to see that, let me know, and I will make it happen, like up to once a week even. So I think that would be really fun. And then here's some pictures from the zoo, which reminds me I need to go to the zoo too. I really do. Oh, that's beautiful. So many orchids. All right, and let's check out the fan art. And admire after the letter, it says. That's cute. That's really cute. Okay. Oh, wow. So here's Dawn. Do you guys remember our puppy Dawn? This is what I mean by the way Wolf Quest can be so fun for me, even when it's the same two levels. And by the way, Wolf Quest is having an update pretty soon with cougars. That's going to be amazing. The same two levels because you guys sent in so much beautiful artwork and you're just so excited about Wolf Quest. And it makes me excited. All right. And then we have... I can't find my nest. I'm scared. Oh my gosh, it's the Star Stable fan art because we rescued the little hedgehogs. Remember when we rescued the little baby hedgehogs? I loved that quest so much. I actually added my garden hedgehogs in zoo crafting, and the garden hedgehogs will drop like summer flowers. And I love this. I absolutely love this. This is adorable. Oh my gosh. Those hedgehogs are so cute. Okay, so let's see. And then ponies. Oh, I'm going to have to show my niece. She loves My Little Pony. Like, really, 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 really loves My Little Pony. There we go. She's gonna love this. Oceana, I'm gonna have to show her because she has so many Berry Float. She's got a lot of ponies and a lot of My Little Pet Shop. Those are like her two biggest passions in the world. Lemonheart. The names, I swear, it would almost be fun to do like Magenta. The names kind of remind me, like with Lemonheart, of warrior cats in a way, don't they? But thank you so much, Lissy. I hope you're having a wonderful day. Sorry if I got way too serious earlier, but like I said, it's just sometimes when someone asks you a serious question, it deserves a serious answer. All right, so especially when your name is Seri. So here we have one from Shelby, also in Ohio. And it says, you may show on camera and peace all over the back. That's so cute. Oh, leaves and hearts everywhere. All right, open it really carefully. And let's see what we have hiding in here. All right. So we've got... Oh, it's so cute. It's noodles. Dear Seri, you make great videos and you're awesome, Seri. Oh, my big sis is Lissy from Shelby. Oh, Shelby, thank you. I hope you're having a wonderful day, Shelby. Look at all of that. Oh, that's so cute. I hope you two are having a great day. And thank you so much for the fan art. You both are talented artists. And I hope you're having a wonderful summer together because it is summertime now. And then we have a letter from Utah. This looks familiar. It's a leaf on the back. How cool is that? Oh my gosh, that is so neat. I'm going to try to open this as carefully as possible so I don't upset the little leaf. Okay, there we go. Ha. All right, avoiding the leaf. And let's see what we've got from Utah. I've seen this little address sticker before, so I'm pretty sure this is from somebody we've heard before. Whoa! Whose letter is this? Look how pretty. Oh my gosh. So who's this from? Wow. This is... It's, oh my gosh. It's a feather for Robin Kit. Oh my gosh. That's so cute because Robin Kit loves collecting feathers. Oh my gosh. Angeline. Oh my gosh. That's so cool. All right. Ahem. Dear Seri, kudos for pronouncing my name right. Well done. I hope I got that right. All right. I wish that all my teachers could pronounce it as well as you do. I mean, they slaughter it. And I'm sorry if I mispronounce your name at some point, too, because I'm really, 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 really bad with names. It's very embarrassing at family reunions. I'm not going to lie. It's so embarrassing. I've pronounced my cousin, the same cousin who just had the baby cousin, I pronounced her name wrong. Every single time I open my mouth, I say her name incorrectly. And I'm just like, really? And she's very understanding about it. The worst was when I totally walked up to her and said, congratulations, cousin. And then to the new cousin at their wedding, I said her name totally wrong. And I just could have crawled into a hole and died. But she was just the sweetest thing and totally just didn't even blink, just kept going. So if I mispronounce your name, no, it's not personal. I just have a horrible time with it. Let's see. I just don't see how they get Benisi or Benizi. It's a riot seeing substitutes try to get it right, though. Anyways, it's kind of fun to see how the game can throw a wrench in our plans. I don't think that the plot twist was expected by anybody. Dang you, Lightning Star! And you guys will probably see more of Lightning Star very soon in the future. Moss Clan has been really busy with the drama lately. You just had to ruin the Moss Clamp camp, didn't you? And oh my gosh, it is so ruined. It is so ruined. I could not have predicted meteors. You guys were there when the meteors showed up. You don't control meteors landing in Sims 3. It just happens, and it happened. So that was pretty cool. All right, good recovery on that. Right now I'm sitting in the kitchen. It's sweltering 101 Fahrenheit. Ooh, I'm sorry to hear that. And I really wish we had more fans. If it wasn't so hot, I would be out looking for our hummingbird. She comes back every year and builds a new nest. I think it's so fun to watch the progress of how it's built. My baby brother is playing in the living room. I can't believe he's almost 2 years old. Oh, that's really cute. I'm sorry about your grandmother and Zoe. It's never easy to lose family. Almost the exact same thing happened to me. We had just found out our standard poodle had several tumors and that she wasn't going to make it, and the next morning my great-grandma died. I was really sad. I hope you like the feather. I was digging through my craft supplies and thought you might like it. Oh, thank you so much, sweetie. I really do. I love that this, every time I'm looking at this from now on, I'm going to think Robin Kit. That's adorable. That's really, really, really adorable. And thank you so much. It's been an interesting month. This June, you guys, has been pretty intense because I did lose my grandmother and then I lost Zoe. Well, we lost Zoe first, our Great Dane, who you guys can actually see in the old vlogs if you're curious about her. And then my grandmother did pass away. And then Starburst passed away in my hands, my little bird. So he was old as well and he had liver issues. So I was expecting it and I buried him outside under some honeysuckle and it was very fitting for him. But yeah, it's been a bit of a month. And the thing is, you keep expecting to be really sad about it and it comes. It does come, the sadness. But then I get to look around at all of this and I get to remember that there's that trade-off of because you love something, it hurts when you lose it. But you also get to don't let that discourage you from surrounding your life with the things you love and with the people who care about you. And that's why I love doing this. So thank you. Thank you. And thank you. Thank you. It means a lot to have those condolences. All right. And then we've got a letter. I think this is from Nebraska. So let's go ahead. No name on it. We're gonna pop it open. I think I recognize this one. I'm seeing a lot of repeats. We in our pile for the next day, we have a lot of people who I know they've sent them in before. Poppy Frost popsicles. Oh my gosh. Oh, that's so cute. Look at that. That's for Poppy Frost. Poppy Frost is our seal in Star Stable. That is adorable. She would love. I need to build her a popsicle stand in like zoo crafting. That has to happen. We need to have Poppy Frost popsicle stand in zoo crafting for sure, because this is just too cute. Oh my gosh. That's so adorable. Maylee, thank you so much. Thistledown's berry bag. You guys, look at the little thistledown. He even has a little sun hat on and he's got berries everywhere. Oh, that's so cute. Oh my gosh, the Star Stable fan art is so strong today. Thank you so much. Oh, that's beautiful. Oh, I just Oh, the popsicle stand. That would be so cute. So thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I'm gonna have to do more Star Stable pretty soon because we're still really starting to pick up on that. Oh, this is from Canada. From Kay. Oh, cool. So this is from Kay in Canada. Oh, Pogo Fruit and Petal Slimes and Bulbasaur. Please make a Komodo dragon exhibit and sell some dragon fruit. If so, thank you. Oh my gosh, this is so cute. I love the artwork that you guys do. It's so fun. It's just so creative and inspiring. That's what I mean about sad things can happen. And it's respectful, especially when you lose someone, to kind of embrace that time of mourning. But then life's about living it fully and joy, in my opinion. So you gotta embrace it. And let's slide all of this out. Oh my gosh, there's so much stuff. Oh my gosh. Okay, did I get everything? I wanna make sure. Okay, good. Oh my gosh. It's so much. Okay, what do we have here? Okay, let's gently open this up. Here we go. Wow. Wow. It's like a garden of all of the different series we have. 101 Dalmatians. Look, it's a spotted flower. Oh my gosh. Twin Bark Town. Warrior Cats. Slime Rancher. Wolf Quest. Stardew Valley. Pixelmon. Zoo Crafting. Taito Ecology. This is so cool. Oh my gosh, there's more in the back. Shelter 1, 2, and Paws. Spore. Zoo Crafting. Horse Haven. Jurassic Park Builder. Star Stable. Sims 4. Pet World 3D. PPPS, when are the dinos and Pixelmon coming? Soon. At least on the dinos. Pixelmon, I have to see if I can get the mods to play nicely. I said it. I'm working on it. But I have to see if the mods will play nicely, and I have to work on my many, many other projects. But you guys keep sending Pokemon cards, and it keeps getting me so excited. And now Sun and Moon is going to come out. It's based off of Hawaii. I am Hawaiian, so it's really exciting. So yeah, we're going to look into all of that. All right. Hem hem. Hi, Seri, it's me again, Kay. I haven't written to you for a while, but I wanted to see your beautiful, happy expression on your face. I've heard you like Miraculous Ladybug. I do too, and I do. I love Miraculous Ladybug. I've seen pretty much all of it, and I wish it would get over here. I have the season pass. I purchased it on Amazon, and I wish they would get over here faster, because those are the kinds of cool shows I want to give to my nieces and my cousin, or my niece and my cousins. Ugh, there we go again. And I really want them to have those kinds of really cool role models, and the art's awesome. And I like the idea of superheroes that help people deal with their emotions more than just like, rawr, greed, rawr. I'm Lex Luthor, I'm gonna steal everything because I like money. I like things, don't get me wrong, I love Lex Luthor. Well, not really, I like the world he lives in. I love stories like that. But it's really fun in Miraculous Ladybug to see like that they tackle emotional issues. And I think that's a nice shift on things. So I would love it if they could get over here a little quicker. When I heard you like it, I instantly jumped. Anyways, I'm a 9-year-old girl and I love animals and also have a huge passion for plants. Speaking of animals, a couple of days ago I saw a little brown rabbit. And enough about me, more about you. I wanted you to know that lots of people love your work and haters don't know what they're missing out on. I mean, who could not bop the button on something so amazing as you? Oh my gosh, thank you. I drew you a kitty version of you and a red tabby Largo. PPS, I have a weird habit of drawing people as cats. This is your growing garden. Oh, I love this garden too. Thank you, Kay. Oh my goodness. So let's look at the artwork that Kay has made for us. So, oh gosh. All right. So what do we have here? Doves of the Sacred Phoenix Tree. Oh, that's so fun. The doves of the Sacred Phoenix Tree. And you guys will be seeing the Sacred Phoenix pretty soon. I am working on a dog quest in the background right now. It is just a lot of work to do everything, but I just get so excited. There's so many adventures to share with everybody. And then Warrior Cat's Honey Wish as a kitten. Ah, that's so cute. Her passion for honey is about to come back in full force, just to let you guys know. Her obsession with honey is going to really be off the charts pretty soon. All right, and then what do we have here? It's Crowfeather. Ah, here's Crowfeather right here. And then, yeah, there we go. So here's Crowfeather. The things that have happened with him recently are really exciting. I am really looking forward. I have a couple big things in mind, and we'll have to see if they come out that way or not. Oh, it's me as a cat! Seri, the pixel biologist. There are many hibiscuses in this world, but yours is extra special. I can tell. Oh, that's so cool. So there's Seri, the pixel biologist, as a cat. I love it. Oh my gosh, that's awesome. Oh, that's so cute. I love the beautiful, beautiful. Did you guys see this? I mean, look at the little medallion around my neck. That's gorgeous. Thank you so much, Kay. All right, and then I think this is going to be our Largo. So here we go. Rad Tabby Largos. There we go. Oh, thank you, Kay. I am so happy to know you enjoy so many of our adventures. And I love the garden that you drew, too. The little spotted flowers on 101 Dalmatians. Totally cute. Absolutely awesomely cute. Oh, my gosh. All right. So we've got a few things to get through. Some packages now. So let's dive in. I've made these people wait too long. This one is from Alicia in Colorado. And I want to open it very carefully. So from Colorado. I've never been to Colorado, but I actually probably will start going pretty soon. Michigan's closer to Colorado than I am at in North Carolina. So we'll probably start traveling over there, especially because we love the mountains. And we're going to be missing the mountains after we move from North Carolina to Michigan. All right, what's in here? Oh, wow. There's like really fancy, beautiful paper. I want to try to pull it out as carefully as possible. All right, let's try opening it like this. The paper doesn't want to move, so I want to be very gentle with it. All right, let's see. All right, Alyssa, I'm very excited. I can tell this is very carefully packaged artwork, so I'm trying to be super, super delicate, gentle with it. And, okay, is it going to scooch? There we go. Wow! Oh my gosh! Wow! You guys, look at that. Oh my gosh, that's beautiful. Alyssa, oh my gosh. That's amazing. That's absolutely amazing. Wow, okay. Dear Seri, I recently turned 12 and wanted to write you a letter for my birthday because I love your channel. I adore how enthusiastic you are when it comes to biology and how much you know about nature. You are one of the only YouTubers that I can relate to when it comes to your knowledge about the natural world. Whenever I talk about animals at school, everyone gives me this look. I'm pretty sure you know what I mean. Yes. Yes, Alyssa. Trust me, growing up, like, everybody was like, do you have to be a walking encyclopedia? And, like, animals aren't that cool. And I'm like, yeah, they are. Don't worry, there's people like us out there. There are. We're a whole community of people like this now. You really inspire me to share my ideas more because when you have an idea for a video, it turns out great. Anyway, I feel like this letter is long overdue because I have been watching your videos for a couple months and wrote nothing, so sorry if this letter is kind of long. First off, I really want to share these two games with you that aren't released, yet they're both about animals and made by one person. Way to the Woods and Home Free. One is about a mommy deer escorting her fawn through unknown territory, and the other is about surviving as a stray dog in the big city. Which brings me to my next topic, ideas. I think it would be really cool if you had a stray dog pack in Sims 3 like you have in The Warriors. Maybe the dog pack could interfere with the Clat Clans. Okay, this is the last thing. Have you ever rescued a stray animal? Okay, I'm definitely going to be doing a stray pack in The Sims 3. I'm trying to decide if I'm going to base it off survivors or if it's just going to be like a stray life as a pack challenge. So I'm going to I don't know if I can read through all of the Survivor series fast enough to do it before summer. So we might do like life as a stray pack challenge, but we'll see. We'll see. This is the kick in the rump that I need to start reading the Survivor series so that we can figure it out. And I have rescued many stray animals, mostly cats, because they're pretty easy to rescue as strays. And then a few times, like baby bunnies that needed help that got like kind of dumped on my doorstep by my cats. A lot of wild birds that I just kind of needed a little bit of TLC to be able to be released back into the wild that, again, my cats would bring to me. We no longer let our cats outside, just for the record. And let's see. Because there are many strays in Russia, whenever I go to visit my grandpa, I like to feed them and watch their behavior. Last time I visited, I rescued a stray cat named Basa. He has long fur and is all white, and Basa is a purring machine. I know he likes me because he follows me around and lays on my stomach all the time. I should probably stop writing now, so I'm just going to say goodbye and keep posting videos because you're awesome. Love, Alyssa. And P.S. Sorry if you can't pronounce my name correctly. I'm sorry if I pronounce your name incorrectly, and this is gorgeous. Just look at this, you guys. Isn't this amazing? Look at the detail. Thank you so much. And how awesome you get to visit your grandpa in Russia. That's amazing. Not only are you a talented artist, but you get to travel the world. That's really cool. And great job on helping out the stray animals. And I am so glad that you enjoy animal things as well. It's really hard when you feel like you're the only person who's this excited about the natural world. But I just want you guys to know you're not alone. There's lots of people out there, and I'm definitely one of them, who has such a passion for the natural world and like encyclopedic knowledge that you keep rattling around in your head over what's going on. And just embrace it. If you really embrace who you are, and you nurture the things that you know are good in your life, then you'll grow into somebody that will have no regrets. And if you keep selling yourself short or you keep kind of stifling the things that you really love because you think that it'll make you more acceptable to like this person or that person or make somebody that you like happier, you'll turn around later, and even if you did make those people happier, you'll find it's really hollow after a while and you'll be very disappointed. So don't be disappointed. Embrace yourself and go for it. So, all right, we're gonna go ahead and open up a couple more packages. Goodness, I've rambled so much today. I'm so sorry about that. I've just been very excited. All right, so we've got this one from, I think, Nebraska, and it doesn't have a name on it. So I'm gonna go ahead and pop it open, and we'll have to see what's hiding inside. It's very neatly put together, so this is very well done. Nothing is going to have escaped out of here without anybody's knowledge. So I'm pretty sure this one's from Nebraska. Not New Mexico. All right, I need my little abbreviation chart that someone made for me a while. Wow, holy days. Oh my gosh, there's so much art in here. Oh my goodness, okay. All right, look at this. Oh, look at it. Oh, that's so cool. It's Seri the Pixel Biologist. Oh, look at my hibiscus. It's a green hibiscus. That would be so awesome. Oh my gosh. Wow, Hi Seri, it's Cracker Jack, and it's time to crack some jokes. What do you call Tate when he's grumpy? An oldest grumpy fish. And you know what you would call a planaholic, which I like? What do I call my kids? Little crackers. And what do they work as? Cracker medallions. Cracker medians. Oh, Cracker Jack! Cracker Jack is one of our birds from Zoo Crafting. That's hilarious. Oh my gosh. Idea for Lily. Get a pink lily pad and rename it Lily's Lily Pad and keep it in her pack always. That's really sweet. Oh my goodness, who's this from? We're gonna have to keep going till we find the letter. Wow, idea for Tate. Enchant a fish. Can you enchant fish? Is that something you can do? And rename it Tate's Super Fish and keep it in his pack always. I love those ideas. That would be really cool. Oh my gosh. And then we have a beautiful swan. If you guys remember the swans and cygnets that are over at Willow's Lake. Is it Willow's Lake? Is that what we decided? It's Tate's Lake. Why did I say Willow's Lake? I'm not sure. Beautiful flower. Look at all that color. Oh my gosh. So much color. Oh wow. Look at the text on this. Look at that. That's amazing. Look at the Zudesianess. Oh my gosh. That is so awesome. Then we have Amethyst Mist. Oh, our pony Amethyst Mist from Warsaven. That is so cool. This is amazing. This is so much amazing art. I'm going to have like a whole new section in my scrapbook for this. Oh, you guys. Stardew Valley fan art. Look, it's all of our little chick chicks. It's Zinnia and Sweet Pea and Noodle Doodles, and there's Marigold and Foxglove, and there's Cattail, our duck, and there's Bluebell and Peapod and Asparagus, our dinosaurs, and Primrose, our cow. I love it! Oh my gosh! I love Stardew Valley so much! Here's Martha the Second doing accounting. How to read, how to write. Martha the Second, who is our dodo, who takes care of the accounting and Zoo Crafting. This is so creative! And I haven't even found the letter yet. Here's Starburn. Starburn, for those of you guys who don't know, is our really amazing tier 3 fully diamond skill horse in Horsehaven. And she was a lot of work to get there, but it was totally worth it. This is amazing. This is, I think, the first fan art I've ever had of Starburn. This is really awesome. Oh my gosh. Grandpa Atlas, I'll keep sending you lucky rabbit's feet with Draco to you. Oh, sending those lucky rabbit's feet to Geo. Oh, do you guys remember that? Oh, that's so cool. That's Wolf Quest. Oh my gosh. And then we have Goodbye Draco, Stardance with her collar, her radio collar on, Quartz, Mira, and Time, who all got their bath because our wolf pups rolled around in some poison plants a little while ago in Wolf Quest. Remember that? This is what I mean about Wolf Quest being so special, because of the way that you guys just turn it into such an amazing interaction with the stories and the adventures. And this is just phenomenal. The details. I am so blown away. Morel mushrooms, the enchanted fish and Tate, Lily and her flowers. We've got mushrooms everywhere that I love, the vines. There's Martha sitting in her chair. There's Noodle Doodles with noodles because he's going to open up the ramen shop pretty soon. There's the hibiscus. Look at that chicken. This is just details. My weakness. My A plus 100% absolutely love it weakness is details. I am so happy right now. And then Pongo and Perdita kissing in a tree. Oh my gosh, this is so cute. Ah, a cow plant! Oh my gosh! And Moss Leaf, oh my gosh, there's not even a letter. And Rose Stone, thank you, anonymous amazing person, for your absolutely stunning artwork and all of the details and the way you clearly love our adventures and our stories, because you've shown so many of the details that other people may not think about here. This is amazing. This is absolutely amazing. Oh my gosh. Okay. Well, I have some more and I have some bad news. I'm about to run out of space on my phone. So we're going to end Snail Mail here today, and then we'll pick up with more stuff either tomorrow or in a couple days, because wow, this is a lot of snail mail. This is a lot of amazing art. I am really, really, really blown away. And like I said earlier, just surround your life with joy and love and embrace the sad things, because the sad doesn't take up all of the room that the happy things can have too. They can be there side by side. And that's what this month has really been about for me. And you guys, thank you. Thank you. All of this. All of these details, all of these little glimpses into your lives, and the questions, and just knowing what we share together means so much to me. So we're gonna go ahead and stop now, even though I'm so close to this giant package. Don't worry, Panda, I will get there. And we will finish up in another couple days because there's still so much. Like, there's a whole nother stack that I was saving for like a whole nother snail mail video that I need to get through. And this has been amazing. And I can't wait to do more. And I'm so happy, you guys. And I will see you guys next time. Thank you so much. This is why I'm getting an office, so I can show all of this stuff off and just be surrounded by knowing what our adventures mean to you guys. And I'll see you all next time. Bye, guys.